Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to design and assemble a beautiful bench vise in SOLIDWORKS. I hope you like it. So let's see how to do in SOLIDWORKS. We will design each and every part separately and assemble at the end of video. So there are many parts, we will make each and every part. So let's see how to do in SOLIDWORKS. This is very beautiful tutorial. This time I am not going to show the dimension PDF file here, so you have to make your own. Now here we will start the first part of voice base. So let's start. Select front plane sketch and select corner rectangle, and here draw a corner rectangle. Okay, now select the origin point and select this line and make a relation midpoint. Okay, now let's define the width and height. Select the length 2.75 inch and keep the height 1.562 inch. Okay, and extrude it. Keep mid plane and extrude up to 7.25 inch. Okay, now this is the our first part. Define the base metal chrome plate. That's it. This is the base metal. Now select this back surface sketch normal. Select a line and start from this corner. And go back to the point and create. And connect up to here. Exit. Now select this line, curve and line tangent. This is the important relation. Now let's define it. (1.25 inch) and overall height 1.75 inch, and this length define first radius. (1.375 inch). Okay. Now just reduce. Select this. Do one thing, just delete these relations. Now see that it's moving. Now select this line horizontal. Now define this gap. Okay. 1.17887 inch. Okay, this is our perfect design. Now let extrude it, select extruded boss and here choose up to surface. Select this as a surface. Okay. Now select this face, sketch, normal. First draw a center line. Make sure the line is vertical. Now define the length 2.25 inch. Okay. Select a line. Draw a line up to here and just draw a circle. Connect with this line bottom and connect this end. Exit. Now select these two lines. Make relation collinear and one more relation equal. Okay. Now define this radius 0.687 inch. Okay. Now define the height from origin point 2.187 inch. Now the design is fully defined, so let's try to extrude. Choose here offset from surface, make 5 inch and select offset from surface, select this line, offset from this surface 5 inch. See merge result. Okay. Now this faces we will assign some color. Go to painted car and define glossy blue. This face also, so that design looks better. Okay. Now select bottom face, sketch normal, and here we want to draw a wings or a base. Let's select circle. Draw a circle up to this end. Select line, connect this end to this end. Exit. Choose trim entity and trim this half circle. Okay. Now define this radius 1.125 inch. Okay. Now select. Let's draw first and draw a line. Now select circle, keep the diameter 0.312 inch and the distance from this line, this point, 2 inch, and the distance from upper mid point 2.5 inch. Okay, the design is fully defined. Now select extruded boss. Point 4 inch. Reverse direction. Select this material glossy blue. Now we want to just mirror this. Choose right plane, mirror, and select extruded boss. Okay, now it is mirror. Now this two again we want to mirror. Choose front plane, mirror, select extruded boss and mirror. Okay, now see the base already is mirror. Now select this face, sketch, normal, and here we want to create some cutout for movement of for path. Actually make sure it is vertical. Now select a line. Select this line vertical. Now select these three lines, make relation symmetric. The same these three lines symmetric. Now bottom line 1.25 inch, the upper line length keep 1 inch, and the distance from bottom face (1.6875 inch), and the same this second line 1.062 inch. Okay, now select this line and this line make relation collinear. Okay, now our geometry is fully defined, so we want to cut. Select extruded cut and select here through all. Okay, now see we cut it a cutout. This is the cutout for movement. Now here we will make some tap hole this face, so choose hole wizard. Now select straight tap inch and here choose bottoming tapped hole, and here select 1/4 20. The blinds height 0.05 inch. Choose position, press escape, and first draw a center line. Now select star, draw one here. Now press escape. Now define this distance. (0.75 inch). And the distance from here to this corner 1 inch. Okay. Now select mirror, select this against this line. Okay, now see it is mirror, select okay. Now we can see it here, the hole is created, tapped hole. Now select this face, sketch, normal. And here we want to create a hole for thread. Select this circle just and find out this center point and keep the diameter 0.5625 inch. Okay, and select extruded cut and keep here up to next. This is the next part, next phase. Now see the hole is created. Keep chamfer 0.075 mm, 5 inch. Okay. Now we want to create some thread here. First select this face circle a sketch and select this inside circle, convert. Now select helix and spiral. We want to create here paths for thread. So do one thing, select height and pitch constant, height keep (4.025 inch) and the pitch (0.125 inch), 90 degree reverse clockwise, tapered 0 degree. Okay, even it's no need to check in. Okay, now the path is selected. Now select right plane, is sketch normal, and here we will create profile. So select center line and connect this midpoint to this midpoint. Select this line and make relation vertical. Now we will define the height first. 0.0625 inch, and this width 0.079 inch, and let's define the angle. Keep angle 29 degree. Okay. Now select here this point and this, and make relation this path pierce. See, it is pierced here. Now exit. Now just go to feature and select swift cut. Now see here, profile is selected, and just we will select path. Select path. Now see, it is already calculated the path. Select OK. Now see, the threads are created inside. See. Now we will assign some fillets to complete this base. Choose fillet. 0.25 inch. Select both the end. Select inside. Select this side also. Okay. It will may take time. Choose this fillet. Now again choose fillet, 0.125 inch, and select this face. Select the another direction, this face. See, this all face selected, 0.125 inch. Okay, it will may take time. Again you have to define the color glossy blue. Now we will take one more time, 0.005 inch, and select this base. Select this base and this base. Okay. Now that's it. Symmetric. Now this is our base. This is our base is ready. base for mechanical voice. Now save this. Go to desktop and create a new folder, bench voice. Now this is the first part, base. Save. Let's make the next part,